Hi friends, welcome to the channel The Nurse. Here we are discussing about burns related nursing questions and answers with their rationales. If you are not subscribed to our channel, please subscribe. Question starts now. First question.
In the following types of burns, regeneration occurs without scarring, except. In the following types of burns, regeneration occurs without scarring, except. First degree burns, second degree burns, third degree burns, none of these. Correct answer, third degree burns. The deeper layers of the corium are not destroyed in first and second degree burns. Regeneration occurs without scarring. The deeper layers of the corium are not destroyed in first and second degree burns. Regeneration occurs without scarring. Next question. Pain occurs more in the first degree and second degree burns because of. Pain occurs more in the first degree and second degree burns because of. Release of high prostaglandins by brain. Nerve endings have been injured and exposed. Destruction of sebaceous gland due to increased perspiration. The correct answer. Nerve endings have been injured and exposed. Next question. During the healing phase, after the burn injury, the person experienced dryness and itching because of. During the healing phase after the burn injury, the person experienced dryness and itching because of. Dehydration, fluid volume shift to interstitial space, increased vascularization, decreased perspiration. Increased perspiration. Correct answer, increased vascularization and decreased perspiration. During the healing phase, the person experiences dryness and itching because of increased vascularization, decrease of sebaceous gland and decreased perspiration. During the healing phase, the person experiences dryness and itching because of increased vascularization, destruction of sebaceous gland and decreased perspiration. Next question. The following formulas are used to find the extent of the burn, except. The following formulas are used to find the extent of burn, except. Charles formula, rule of 9, Berko formula, Lund and Braudhoff method. Correct answer, Charles formula. Next question. The goals of management of burns include all of the following except. The goals of management of burns include all of the following except. Stopping the burn process, providing the life support, preventing complication, prevent the restoration of function. Correct answer, prevent the restoration of function. Next question. The progress of clients experiencing severe burns can be described as following three phases, except. The progress of clients experience having severe burns can be described as following three phases, except. Hypovolemic, rehydration, diuretic, rehabilitative. Correct answer, rehydration. Next question. The hypovolemic phase of burns is initiated at the time of injury and lasts for. The hypovolemic phase of burns is initiated at the time of injury and lasts for 6 to 8 hours, 6 to 12 hours, 12 to 24 hours, 48 to 72 hours. Correct answer, 48 to 72 hours. The major characteristics of hypovolemic phase is a rapid fluid shift from the vascular compartment to the interstitial compartment. The major characteristic of hypovolemic phase is a rapid fluid shift from the vascular compartment to the interstitial compartment. Next question. What is the main cause of local edema and blister formation at the burn area? what the main cause of local edema and blister formation at the burn area. Increase the production of lymph, hypothermia, to protect burn area from heat, vasodilation and increased capillary permeability. Correct answer, vasodilation and increased capillary permeability. When the tissue are burned, vasodilation, increased capillary permeability and changes in the permeability of tissue cells in and around the burn area occur. As a result, abnormally large amounts of extracellular fluid, sodium chloride and proteins pass into the burn area to cause blister formation and local edema. When the tissues are burned, vasodilation, increased capillary permeability and changes in the permeability of tissue cells in and around the burn area occur. As a result, abnormally large amount of extracellular fluid, sodium chloride and proteins pass into the burnt area to cause blister formation and local edema. Next question, what will happen to a severe burn patient as a result of the reduced blood volume and passage of the end products of the hemolyzed cells through the glomeruli? What will happen to a severe burn patient as a result of the reduced blood volume and passage of the end products of the hemolyzed cells through the glomeruli? Septic shock, renal damage and hematuria, glomerulonephritis, ascites. Correct answer, renal damage and hematuria. Red blood cells trapped in the burnt area are destroyed and the injured cells continue to hemolyze. It will lead to renal damage and hematuria. RBCs are trapped in the burnt area are destroyed and the injured cells continue to hemolyze. It will lead to renal damage and hematuria. Next question, what is the reason for metabolic acidosis in hypovolemic phase of burn injury? What is the reason for metabolic acidosis in hypovolemic phase of the burn injury? Increased respiration, decreased respiration, increased production of bicarbonate, anaerobic metabolism and loss of serum bicarbonate. Correct answer, anaerobic metabolism and loss of serum bicarbonate. Anaerobic metabolism from decreased tissue perfusion leads to increased acid and acid end product, that is lactic acid, and decreased urine output. That also leads to retention of acid end products along with loss of serum bicarbonate leads to metabolic acidosis. Anaerobic metabolism from decreased tissue perfusion leads to increased acid end product, that is lactic acid, and decreased urine output also leads to retention of acid end product along with loss of serum bicarbonate leads to metabolic acidosis. Next question, the main cause of diuretic phase of burns is. The main cause of diuretic phase of burn is fluid shift from vascular compartment to interstitial compartment. Fluid shift from interstitial compartment to vascular compartment. Administration of injection furosemide. Hypotension. Correct answer, fluid shift from interstitial compartment to vascular compartment. That is opposite to the hypovolemic phase. Next question, persons who are burnt on the face and neck or those who have inhaled flame, steam or smoke should be closely observed for. Persons who are burnt on the face and neck or those who have inhaled flame, steam or smoke should be closely observed for. Possibility of cosmetic surgery, identity problem and self-esteem, laryngospasm and airway obstruction, risk for scarring. Correct answer, laryngospasm and airway obstruction. Next question, important initial care when chemical burn is suspected. Important initial care when chemical burn is suspected. Cover the burn area, excessive flushing with water for 20 to 30 minutes, remove the dressings, provide the calm environment. Correct answer, excessive flushing with water for 20 to 30 minutes. As much as 20 to 30 minutes of continuous flushing may be necessary to assure complete removal of the destructive agent. As much as 20 to 30 minutes of continuous flushing may be necessary to assure complete removal of destructive chemical agent. Next question. Applying ice should be avoided at the burnt area because. Applying ice should be avoided at the burnt area because large ice cubes may not be available. It may lead to infection. It may break the blisters. Leads to severe vasoconstriction. Correct answer. It may lead to severe vasoconstriction. Ice is to be avoided since the severe vasoconstriction decreases circulation to the part and increases pain. Ice to be avoided since the severe vasoconstriction decreases circulation to the part and increases pain. Next question. Large doses of analgesics and sedation should be avoided for the burnt patient because. Large doses of analgesics and sedation should be avoided for the burnt patient because there was no pain at all. It will not relieve pain. It may cause respiratory depression. It may cause addiction. Correct answer. It may cause respiratory depression. Large doses of analgesics and sedatives are avoided because of the danger of respiratory distress, depression, and it may mask other symptoms. Next question. The one half of the total amount of the fluid needed in first 24 hours should be given within. The one half of the total amount of the fluid needed in first 24 hours should be given within. First 24 hours after injury. First 12 hours after injury. First 4 hours after injury. First 8 hours after injury. Correct answer. First 8 hours after injury. Fluids needs for the first 24 hours are calculated from the time of the burn. Usually, the patient receives one half of the total amount of the first total amount in the first 8 hours, 1/4 in the second 8 hours, and another 1/4 in the third 8 hours. One half of the total amount given in the first day is given in the second 24 hours. One half of the total amount given in the first day is given in the second 24 hours. Next question. The most reliable measure for determining the adequacy of fluid therapies during the first 48 hours of burns. The most reliable measure for determining the adequacy of fluid therapy during the first 48 hours of the burn. Electrolyte level, urine output, serum potassium level, skin turgor. Correct answer, urine output. Urine flow 30 to 50 ml is adequate for an adult. Urine flow should be at least 15 ml per hour for infants and 25 ml per hour for older children. After the first 48 to 72 hours, the urinary output is no longer reliable guide to fluid needs because diuretic phase may initiate. After the first 48 to 72 hours, the urine output is no longer reliable guide to fluid needs because diuretic phase may initiate. Next question. The third solution is prepared by equal parts of mixture of the following solutions except. The third solution is prepared by equal parts of mixture of following solutions except. Povidone iodine, normal saline, acetic acid, hydrogen peroxide. Correct answer is povidone iodine. The third solution has limited antimicrobial action and is most effective against organisms that are affected by changes in the pH. The third solution has limited antimicrobial action and is most effective against organisms that are affected by changes in pH. It is also used to clean the dirty granulation tissue. It is also used to clean the dirty granulation tissue. The protein requirement for an adult patient who got major burn injury is. The protein requirement for an adult patient who got major burn injury is 0.5 gram per day, 0.5 to 1 gram per day, 500 to 1000 milligram per day, 2 to 4 gram per day. Correct answer, 2 to 4 gram per day. Next question. Which among the following intervention is not used to prevent contractures on face and neck involved patient? Which among the following intervention is not used to prevent contractures on face and neck involved patient? Semi-folded position, neck hyperextended position, supine with pillow under the shoulder, chewing gum and blowing balloons exercises. Correct answer, semi-folded position. Semi-folded position is not used to prevent the contractures of the face and neck of the burned patient. The question ends here. Thank you for watching this video. Please like and share this video and don't forget to subscribe our channel, The Nurse. Thank you.